Introduction and Dramatis Personae for Jephtha by Thomas Morell. Jephtha, an oratorio or sacred drama, as it is performed at the Theatre Royal in Covent Garden, set to music by Mr. Handel. Dramatis Personae. Jephtha, read by Alan Mapstone. Zabel, his brother,
read by Larry Wilson.
Storge, his wife,
read by Sonia.
Iphis, his daughter,
read by Agnes Robert Baer.
Hamor, in love with Iphis,
read by Adrian Stevens.
Angel,
read by Rapunzelina.
Chorus of Israelites,
read by Greg Giordano.
Chorus of Virgins,
read by Rapunzelina.
Chorus of Priests,
read by Inko.
Narration. Part 1 of Jephtha by Thomas Morell.
Part 1, Scene 1. Zebel with his brethren, etc.
It must be so. Are these vile Ammonites our lordly tyrants now, these 18 years? Will crush the race of Israel. Since heaven vouchsafes not with immediate choice to point us out a leader as before, ourselves must choose. And who so fit a man as Gilead's son, our brother valiant Jephtha? True, we have slighted, scorned, expelled him hence, as of a stranger born. But well I know him. His generous soul disdains a mean revenge when his distressful country calls his aid. And perhaps God may favor our request if with repentant hearts we sue for mercy. No more pour forth unheeded prayers to idols deaf and vain, no more with vile unhallowed airs the sacred rites profane.
No more to Amon's God and King, fierce Moloch shall our cymbals ring, in dismal dance about the furnace blue. Chemosh no more will we adore, with timbreled anthems to Jehovah do.
Scene 2. Enter Jephtha, Storge, etc.
But Jephtha comes. Kind heaven, assist our plea. O Jephtha, with an eye of pity, look on thy repentant brethren in distress. Forgetful of thy wrongs, redress thy sire, thy friends, thy country, in extreme despair.
I will, so please it heaven, and these the terms. If I command in war, the like command, should heaven vouchsafe us a victorious peace, shall still be mine.
Agreed. Be witness, heaven.
Virtue my soul shall still embrace, goodness shall make me great. Who builds upon this steady base, dreads no event of fate.
'Twill be a painful separation, Jephtha, to see thee harnessed for the bloody field. But ah, how trivial are a wife's concerns when a whole nation bleeds and grovelling lies, panting for liberty and life. In gentle murmurs I will mourn, as mourns the mate-forsaken dove, and sighing with thy dear return to liberty and lasting love.
Exeunt. Scene 3. Enter Hamor and Iphis.
Happy this embassy, my charming Iphis, which once more gives thee to my longing eyes. As Cynthia, breaking from long darkening clouds on the benighted traveller, the sight of thee, my love, drives darkness and despair. Again I live, in thy sweet smiles I live, as in thy father's ever-watchful care. Our wretched nation feels new life, new joy. Oh, haste, and make my happiness complete. Dull delay in piercing anguish bids thy faithful lover languish, while he pants for bliss in vain.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.